say can be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, some never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are thirsty in Atlanta, and there's beer in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run. They say can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run. Old Smokey's got them ears on. He's hot on your trail. He ain't gonna rest till you're in jail. So you got to dodge him, you got to duck him. You gotta keep that diesel trucking. Just put that hammer down and give it hell. Eastbound and down, are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run.
In this year's edition of AP Macro Videos. And today we're going to be talking about T accounts and the financial sector. Every year that I teach this class, and I've been teaching a little while now, when we get to this part of the year, when we're prepping for the exam, there's always a few topics that come up, and T accounts is invariably one of those topics. It's a unique topic, it's a different topic. You could argue it's not even economics. So today we're going to take an in-depth look at T accounts, look at how they relate to the financial sector, and most importantly, how we can use them as a tool to explain money creation in the financial sector. My name is Matt Romano. I'm coming to you from Atlanta, Georgia, Marist School, and let's get started. Let's talk T-accounts. So, as I said, what are we going to learn today? We're going to learn about T-accounts. We're going to learn about T-accounts within the context of the financial sector, and most importantly, learn about them as a tool that is used to help explain that money creation process, sometimes initiated by monetary policy, sometimes initiated simply by bank lending and bank business. What skills are we gonna practice? This is really important. Sometimes we neglect the skills. We get so locked into content that we forget. We're really trying to develop skills in this class, skills that you're gonna use well beyond the end of this course, well into your life outside of school. So the skills that we're going to talk about, first of all, just almost definitional. What is a T account? What the heck are we talking about with this thing? Being able to define what it is, being able to understand the different uses and applications of T accounts throughout the AP macro class. We're going to explain money creation, as I've already said a number of times, both forwards and backwards, looking at how a particular action can create a certain amount of money, and looking backwards, what would be required to create a certain level of money creation. We're going to determine the effects of deposit expansion and money supply, and be able to take a set of data and make predictions and work through calculations based upon that. And then finally, we're going to take what we learned from a T account, and we're going to illustrate that on a graph of the money so that we can then learn about changes in interest rates and apply that back to the broader economy through ADAS analysis. So all of that, just from this in-depth look at T accounts in the financial sector, just trying to acquire this better understanding of this particular concept so we can apply it in a much broader sense. So let's warm up. We're going to warm up with just a little bit of definitional work. Again, what are we talking about today, and how do we wrap our heads around this thing, the T account? So three primary questions I want to start with. What is a T account? And then within the T account, what are assets, what are liabilities? And you can see here, I've got a generic T account label down here. Just a nice, easy little picture, and it should be pretty obvious where the name T account comes from. And if it's not, just look a little more closely at the lines. A T account, if you want a formal definition, a T account is what depository institutions use to organize their assets and liabilities. It's a balance sheet. That's exactly what it is. It's a balance sheet. They don't only apply to banks. They don't only apply to depository institutions. That's the application that we're going to use in this class. T accounts are an accounting tool. They're accounting method. And frankly, I'm not qualified to teach you accounting. I'm qualified to teach you AP macroeconomics. So we could, if we wanted to go the accounting route, we could actually look at T accounts, not only for banks, but for private businesses. You could do a T account for the central bank, for the Fed. You could do a T account for your own household if you wanted to, and use that to better understand the balance between assets and liabilities. If we're going to do that, we have to know what assets and liabilities are. So let's take just a moment. Let's talk about that. And again, make sure we understand what assets and liabilities are. Assets, the left-hand side of the T account as you look at it, represent items of value. Items of value which are owned or controlled by whatever entity this T account represents. So in the context of AP Macro, we are looking strictly at bank T accounts. So on the left-hand side of a T account, these are the items of value owned by the bank, controlled by the bank, which the bank is going to use to try to increase the overall value of that entity of the bank. So we're talking about bank reserves, loans, securities, plant and equipment, and potentially many, many more. These are the primary ones that we see applied in AP Macro. Individually, let's understand what these assets are. Bank reserves, essentially, the way we want to look at it, are the flip side of demand deposits. It's the money that banks have available to use in order to increase the value of their other assets, assets such as loans. We know what a loan is. The bank has extra reserves, excess reserves. They lend it out to a private party or even potentially government in order to do something else. From the bank's perspective, that loan is an asset because that asset, that loan, has a future value. That future value, which is defined by the interest rate. Look at that in just a second. Application. Securities could be private, they could be public. Again, in the context of AP Macro, we are usually talking about government securities. If we're talking in the United States, we're talking about Treasury security deficit. They do that because, just like in the case of the loan, they are paid interest on that money. They're paid interest on that asset. And then finally, plants and equipment can refer to any of that physical capital, that equipment that the bank itself may own in order to operate the business. Again, these are considered items of value because, for one, they can sell them and receive the value as payment. But number two, they help facilitate the business of the bank so that they can increase the value of other assets and do the business of the bank. On the other side, the flip side of the T account, we have liabilities. Liabilities are financial obligations. They are owed to someone else. And again, there could be a whole list of other liabilities on this bank T account. But in this course, because again, we try to keep it pretty simple, we really focus on two bank liabilities. Number one, demand deposits. Number two, demand deposits refers obviously to money deposited by the customers of the bank. These are checking accounts. These are savings accounts. This is money that is owed back to depositors whenever they want it. That's why they're called demand deposits. This is where banking begins. You can't have anything on the asset side. We're going to look at this with some numbers. If you don't first have something on the liability side, specifically on the deposit side. Without deposits, there really isn't a bank. There's no business. Owner's equity, which dollars to essentially the return back to the owners of the bank, the equity, the amount of ownership returned back to the bank itself, to the owners of the bank itself. And what we're going to show here is that, as illustrated on a T account, the most basic interpretation of a bank's business model is to take demand deposits, treat them as assets, as reserves, increase their values so as to create owner's equity and return back to the owner. And on that point, I just want you to keep one little thing in mind. Banks are businesses. And when we say that, we have to consider the incentive behind starting and or owning a bank. As a business, just like any other type of private financial investment, the starter of the bank, the owner of the bank, is seeking a positive return. We see this all the time. We see it all the time at AB Mac, because again, economics is all about why we do the things that we do. So why do owners start the business of a bank to get a positive return? Well, that owner's equity represents the potential positive return of those owners. So the most simple, again, explanation of what a bank is trying to do is to take demand deposits, increase their value as assets, and the return goes back to the owners. That's the business model. Again, in real life, it's much more complicated. You get into high finance and a whole lot of other things, but that's the most basic interpretation out there. Let's look at examples. This is a whole lot easier when you just get your hands dirty and start working. Trying to describe it, trying to define it, it can be a little complicated. If we just start working through the numbers, it starts to get a whole lot. So let's look at an example. Let's say you're opening a bank. Today is day one at your new bank. At your new bank, you have a reserve requirement of 10% as set by the central bank. Let's just start with that assumption. Right here, we have an empty T account. Nothing's going on. The first thing we have to do in order to have a bank is we have to convince someone to deposit money in the bank. So let's do that. Start with deposits. Now, when deposits enter the picture, when we first enter deposits on the liability side, just define by the end of the term, we'll look at that in just a second. Securities could be private, they could be public. Again, in the context, you do a T account question in macroeconomics, an AP macro, it'd be a good idea, just as a reminder to yourself, to write down the word ALO. Assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity. So always apply ALO when you're working with the T account. The way that would look right here,